Hello guys and welcome to Crypto Bull. Today we are going to talk about two projects which in my opinion could explode and which could become very talked about subject. But before I jump in into that, I would like to tell sorry to all of you guys, because many of you already know who are on my Patreon, who are on my Telegram, you contacted me and you were saying why I didn't add this hyperchain before I posted it on YouTube to my Patreon and to my Telegram. So sorry guys. The reason was, just so you know guys, who are on my Patreon, who are on my Telegram, that I was posting this video from my phone. This video was preloaded and I posted it or made live on YouTube channel yesterday from my phone, and that's why I didn't post it on my Telegram and on my Patreon, because this was a rather big hassle. And for all of you others who want to get to know about my low cap and micro cap picks first, join my Patreon, links will be in description and in first comment of this video. In future guys, I will make sure that all these my picks are first posted to my Patreon and Telegram, so sorry once again. But today we will be talking about two projects which in my opinion, like I already mentioned, will explode. And these projects could explode because they are building competitor to Ethereum, and they are not built by some unknown developers, but they are being built by Hex developer, who is Richard Hart, guys. And if you don't know him, he is like very controversial person here on crypto space in general. He is a millionaire, maybe even billionaire, guys. I'm not sure whether he is, but he has created Hex, and Hex, for anyone who invested in Hex, everyone made 10,000x on their investment. And now he is working on these two projects. And today we will be talking about Pulse Chain project, and we will be talking about PulsePad, and I will explain you what they are building and what these projects are about. As you have noticed, none of these projects, not a Pulse Chain, not a Pulse Pad, none of them are listed, and this means that these tokens are not live yet. This means that these cryptocurrencies or this blockchain, it is not live yet, it hasn't been yet created, because now they are working on it. However, on Pulse Chain was investment which we talk about a little bit later. Let's talk about these projects, what these projects are and what they are building. And let's start with Pulse Chain. Here, as you can see, if you go in CoinMarketCap, you search for Pulse Chain, which is PLS. If you go here on website, you click here on Pulse Chain website, you can get into their website. And as you can see here guys, energy efficient, cheaper, faster, free burning Ethereum fork. So what is Pulse Chain? This is Ethereum fork. Richard Hart, and like I mentioned, this is being developed by Richard Hart developer teams. What they did, they forked Ethereum. This means that they took a copy of Ethereum at the state at which it was when they were taking this copy, guys, and they made it better. They are actually trying to make it better because it is still not released. The main idea is to make it energy efficient. This means that this Pulse Chain will be fully proof of stake. There will not be proof of work mining, but this will be fully proof of stake cryptocurrency blockchain, but similar as Ethereum. But and like I mentioned, they are trying to make it better, and transaction, as you see, cheaper. This means that transaction fees will be also very cheap, and by faster they mean that in one block, which has in Ethereum currently 12 seconds or 15 seconds when Ethereum transactions are executing, in these 15 or 10 seconds guys, they are going to implement 4 blocks. This means that Pulse Chain block time will be only 3 seconds, 3 or 4 guys, it doesn't really matter, but it will be much faster. And fee burning Ethereum fork, this means that this will be also deflationary. From the very start, this blockchain will be deflationary cryptocurrency, which means guys that the more people will be using this blockchain, the more projects will start applying to this, the more transactions will be happening on this Pulse Chain blockchain, the less circulation supply will be, which will raise the value of this Pulse Chain token, PLS. As we go here, as you can see, shortcut or ticker is PLS. So these are main things which are they are trying to achieve with this Pulse Chain, but this is still not released. But I would recommend all of you guys to be the first on board and to follow both of these projects. And by the way, another thing about Pulse Chain is that anyone who is already having a project on Ethereum, they can simply copy the code and they will be able to integrate or create the same project here on Pulse Chain. pulse chain, which could also absolutely explode this, because if the Ethereum still makes like or implements Ethereum 2.0 for a year or for 2 years, because they are implementing them in phases, guys, then this blockchain will come out before that, and many projects, because of expensive transaction fees, they could start moving to pulse chain, and this could also move away transactions from Ethereum blockchain. I wouldn't be so excited about pulse chain if it would be created, let's say, by some unknown team, guys. But Richard Hart is very well known in crypto space. He is in crypto since 2011. You can find lots of videos out there. He has his own YouTube channel. You can go and check that YouTube channel out for yourself. And here, what happened with pulse chain at the very beginning, as you see, sacrifice phase is over. What is this sacrifice phase, guys? And what was this sacrifice phase? When Richard Hart announced about this project, about creating this Plur project, he announced that everyone who wants, they can already give money or send Ethereum to some address, guys, and those who will be sending this Ethereum to this address, they will be receiving in return these pulse chain PLS tokens when this project will start operating. This means that you can't already invest in this project. However, when this project will start implementing, when this project will start working, I believe that this is one of those projects which we should follow, because this could also become very, very big, guys. Even after they start working and after they release these tokens, after they send these tokens to those first time investors, and by the way, this project collected $630 or $700 million only in this sacrifice phase. And all other information, you can come in and read out about this project yourself. So this is about pulse chain. Now let's talk about pulse pad, and what is pulse pad, and what this pulse pad is tending to do. PulsePad is the project. This is another related project to Pulse Chain, where new projects from Ethereum or any new projects or projects who are just starting to build out, they can apply for IDOs. This means that this will be the platform where new projects on Pulse Chain will be able to apply for IDOs. And as you know, guys, if you invest in IDOs, then straight away after IDO is executed, you can make a huge money. You can make 50x, 100x pretty much in days after IDO, because an IDO tokens for new projects, they are very, very cheap. They are not even 1 cent. For example, for projects, the price for a token which is executed here in IDO, new projects which are being built, it could be 0.001 cent, guys. When these tokens go live, they could cost straight away like 10 cents or 50 cents, which allows for new investors who are investing in new projects which are being built on Pulse Chain to make huge amounts of X's, like 100x and even 1000x pretty much in days. So why this project is so interesting to me? PulsePad, as you can see, token E will also be PulsePad, and they have Telegram, they have like Twitter. You can go and check them out, and you can follow this project as well, because these tokens are also still not implemented. They are still not released. But what is the value of these PulsePad tokens is, if you will be hodling these PulsePad tokens, this will give you the chance to participate in these IDOs first. So another thing is that I'm waiting also for these PulsePad tokens, or for this PulsePad on their Twitter, to announce that they are going to make their own IDO and they are going to sell their tokens. And obviously, most likely, it will not happen before PulseChain will go live and before PulseChain will be implemented, guys. But when the PulseChain will be implemented, then this PulsePad also will start working, and many new projects who will want to build on PulseChain, they will be creating here on PulsePad their IDOs, where everyone who wants to invest in new projects which are built on PulsePad will be able to invest. And that's why I'm looking out for PulsePad tokens, for PulsePad IDO. And as always, guys, this is only what I am doing in crypto space, and this is why I'm paying attention to these two new projects, which I also wanted to share with you. But like I mentioned, tokens are still not released, but they are only in starting stages. Well, PulseChain is coming out soon, and all we need to do to get to know what is happening next with these projects is to follow their Twitter accounts, because like I mentioned, guys, this project is being built by Richard Hart developer teams, they are trying to make Ethereum more efficient, and even if this project will not work in future, you never know what will happen, guys. You never know how crypto space will react to it. Anyway, I believe that this will be very, very loud project out there in crypto space, and in starting stages, I believe that many people or many investors anyway will be investing and will be excited about this project, because Richard Hart and his development team has already proven it with Hex, where, like I mentioned, those who invested in Hex at the very beginning, they made tremendous returns on their investment, guys. So yes, this is what I wanted to share with you in this video. I hope that you found this useful. If you did, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel if you are new, and see you in the next one.